Everyone is talking about the Amiga, but very few people will actually get to see it here. One system that people ought to be talking about, and which everyone can see, is the new system from Amstrad, the Amstrad PCW8256. What Amstrad have done is to acknowledge that a major reason for buying a personal computer is for word processing. And they have produced a word processor, and here's the shop, for a price they claim is less than that of an electric typewriter, £399. With me is Alan Sugar, chairman of Amstrad. Alan, one wonders whether you can actually make a profit at that price, but can you tell us exactly what you get for £399?
Well, what you get is basically what you see here, which is the keyboard, the monitor with the disk drive, and the printer, and of course the software and the CPM operating system.
Now, is the 8256 just a word processor, or does it have other capabilities?
No, it's a CPM computer, and for example, we see it running a spreadsheet there, and this is a famous spreadsheet, SuperCalc 2, and obviously any of the other 8,000 CPM programs that are available throughout the world.
Now, coming back to the use as a word processor, you're selling the system with a dot matrix printer. Don't you feel that people who really want a word processor are going to require letter quality printing?
Well, we offer letter quality printing. This document here demonstrates clearly every single configuration of printing that the machine does. It's much more versatile than the daisy wheel printer, in as much as you can have this miniature typing, bold typing, expanded, smaller typing, letter quality style, italics, and I think really, I'm sure everybody who's seen it so far must agree that one would need perhaps a magnifying glass to really differentiate between this and what people call daisy wheel printing.
Okay, but if people insist on a daisy wheel printer, can you attach one?
If they insist, then they would need to buy the serial interface which is available for this machine, which plugs onto the back and allows them to then plug into another daisy wheel printer if they want to.
And how much extra would that cost?
That's about £70, the serial interface.
Okay. When can we expect to see the 8256 on the market and where?
They'll be in the stores at the end of September, early October.
Right. Now, leaving this system aside, you also launched a new system, the 6128.
That's right.
Has that completely replaced the 664?
Yes, indeed.
So we will not be selling the 664 anymore?
No, that's right.
Now, are you going to offer any kind of trade-in for people who've purchased a 664? Because it's only been on the market for a few months, so they can upgrade to a 6128?
No, not really.
Don't you feel that with people who've given a loyalty to Amstrad, that they really deserve better than just having order system that is now no longer going to be supported?
Well, I don't know what you mean by not supported. Why is it not supported?
There'll be no further development from Amstrad on that particular system.
It is a compatible machine to all the machines in our range, so all of the software which we are developing for all of our three home computers will operate on the 664. They've not been left out in the cold at all.
Okay, Alan, thank you very much. Once again, the choice is up to you, the consumer, as to which system you purchase. So far we've seen the Commodore 128 and the Amstrad PCW8256, both of which have very similar specifications, capabilities, and both of which support CPM. The main difference? One system is almost half the price of the other.
It seems as if Amstrad have adopted the Atari slogan of power without the price, and that means more choice to all of us as consumers, and that can't